Foreign buyers are flooding the U.S. housing market at record rates, and it's driving up prices in prime areas. Joining me now, Jason Meister, a former Trump surrogate and current senior director at Ackman Ziff Real Estate Group. And also here, Sanada Azem, a former vice president at Trump International and presently luxury sales director at Douglas Elliman. Welcome to you both. Sanada, I'll start with you. I think this market is just fascinating because if you buy American, it's everybody but Americans, right, who are in this marketplace. You're working in Florida. What's going on down there? Who is buying? Where are they from?
Right now, Canadians are buying up a storm in Florida. And of course, everyone loves a good deal.
Yes.
And there's a lot of Canadian money coming. We see it as smart money because they want the value, but they also want the lifestyle.
So tell me, in Florida, because I'm curious, what are the hot markets? I know Miami's always a hot place, particularly with South American buyers. But when you look at the whole state, what are the places that are really popping?
Right now, what's popping? Miami, of course. But Delray, it's a small
Delray.
Town.
Delray?
Yes. Really exciting small town. Huh. Canadians love it. Also, they like Fort Lauderdale. So that's
been growing by leaps and bounds, though. I mean, the big story there, Jason, you're in this marketplace, too. You know a lot about it.
Sure.
What do you see when you look at who are the buyers and why are they buying?
Sure. So these reports that we're seeing today of these overseas buyers coming from China and Canada, they're mostly coming to actually Texas and Florida and California, not so much here in New York. Interestingly enough,
yeah.
I would have thought more.
Yeah, I would have thought that
but
too.
But also, the numbers are definitely skewed, Jerry. When you look at these numbers, they're closed deals. And these deals, for some of these deals, they've been in contracts for a year, 12 to 18 months. So they're now closing. There has been a drop in foreign capital, for sure, in the overseas buyers coming to New York specifically. So I think that the numbers are a little bit skewed.
Interesting.
Having said that, I think there's definitely very big optimism about the U.S. market, especially here in New York and Florida and
Gotta Texas. Love it. Gotta love it. It's a great country. I want to talk about these housing start numbers, though, because they were a big surprise. And this has sort of been the missing link in a lot of ways in this housing market here in this country, is that you could get luxury built, but you can't get the entry level built. Mm-hmm. What do you see out there in Florida in particular?
In Florida, a lot of foreign buyers actually like these new homes. And we've noticed that the construction simply cannot keep up, even though we have a lot of cranes out there. They cannot keep up with the demand right now and what we're seeing. So with the new housing starts, I think what we're going to start seeing is that value and cost of land will continue to go up. And the more expensive the labor and land is, really, then it's more difficult for builders to keep up. That's why I think we're seeing there's just a little bit of difference between supply and demand. So we have more demand than supply needs
to
keep up.
Yeah, it keeps those prices high.
Yeah, what I'm seeing here specifically in New York is land values have dropped quite a bit. We had a 22% drop on the price per foot, per buildable foot in New York. And part of that is because there's just too much luxury condo development that's gone on over the last 8 years.
Because it's been nutty. It's been
nutty.
Crazy.
Interest rates have been free. We had interest rates that were free. Everyone became a developer. And it's just too much. We have oversupply of luxury condos.
And that's not true across the country, obviously,
no.
Right?
No.
I mean,
no.
Pockets have that kind of
sure.
success. And certainly, you know, I look at this and I think, you know, is there another shoe to drop? But at the end of the day, we really do want some construction, but we want it at the low end,
we
right,
want it
Jason?
At the low end. We want what I call affordable housing, or we want affordable luxury housing, at least here in Manhattan. What we needed was land to drop so developers could actually make money building to that level of construction. And we're seeing that now. I think, can it fall a little bit lower? Yes, but I don't think we're going to see another shoe to drop. I think that it'll fall a little bit lower, and then we'll build.
All right, let's, you know, hope those millennials get in the market someplace and move
Hopefully.
Out of mom and dad's basement, and that'll help the market. Thanks so much, guys. Great
Appreciate
job.
It.